Good afternoon and welcome to the market wrap for Monday, the 2nd of September. And it was a positive end to the first trading day of a brand new month. It was a different story when we first started off the session. We were down by as much as 0.5%. But as the session went on, we crept higher and higher and we clawed our way back. So we did end up by about 0.1% in today's session. And we also ended about less than 0.5% away from a record high. So we're now at 8,100. And almost 10 points, which is pretty impressive. The last time we hit a fresh record was right at the beginning of August. So all it would take is another good day tomorrow in order to potentially crack that record high. So we'll have to wait and see how we go. Now, in terms of the sectors, more than half of the 11 improved today. Financials led the gains with the four major banks lifting by around 1% and 1.5%. We saw energy stocks performing strongly as well. But on the other end, we saw mining stocks performing worse, the material sector down by 1.1%, and also consumer services was down by almost 1%. Now, looking at some of the individual performers, salary packaging firm Smart Group performed best. Its shares were up by almost 5.5%. CBA hit a fresh record high during the session of $141.77. Contracting firm Downer EDI improved for a second straight session after reporting that it swung to a profit in the full year and also raised its dividends. Its share is hovering near a two-year high following that strong 17% improvement in Friday's session. And Santos today announced that it will divest a 16% stake of its offshore gas project. Looking at the losers, though, gold miners were under pressure today following gold prices lower. In fact, they made up a good chunk of today's losers list. Red 5 did second worst, down by over 7%. Bellevue Gold was right at the top of the losers list, though, despite posting its first ever net profit. Gold stocks as a group, as measured by the gold subsector, fell by 2.5% in today's session, and that's partly why we saw the materials sector doing so poorly today. The company behind realestate.com.au, REA Group, was down 5.5% almost after confirming speculation that they're considering taking over UK's property listing giant Rightmove for roughly $8.5 billion Aussie dollars. So it seems investors weren't overly impressed by the amount of money that they will be spending on that. And Bendigo and Adelaide Bank retreated as it traded ex-dividend. They're scheduled to pay 33 cents per share on the 30th of September. And I just wanted to flag Star Entertainment once again. Its shares have been suspended by the ASX after failing to submit their annual results by the deadline. Now, on Friday, they went into a trading halt and delayed their results after the casino regulator found they hadn't moved fast enough to overhaul their business. That raised fresh doubts about Star holding onto their casino license. So today, as I mentioned, they have been suspended. So we'll have to wait and see what happens moving forward from here. Now, on to currencies. The Aussie dollar is currently buying 67.7 US cents. It certainly has firmed, but it has retreated back below the 68 US cent mark. Now, tonight, US markets will be shut for a public holiday, the Labor Day public holiday. So we won't have US markets to look to for our lead-in into tomorrow's session. We also have a number of stocks trading ex-dividend tomorrow here locally, which could potentially weigh on our share market, including the likes of Coles, Woolies. We also have Endeavour Group, Northern Star, Karoon Energy, and a handful of others.